Morse! Morse! By the gods, Morse. Only you would take on so many wildlings on your own. I was afraid we'd arrive too late.
Indeed. But at what price? My men are dead, as well as those from Cragen's patrol.
In spite of our losses, it is a good day for the Night's Watch. Gorn and his curs would have bled our ranks for years to come.
Despite all that, I owe my life to you and your men.
My honor for the wall. My life for my brothers.
Corrin, there was another ranger with me. A little thief from Fleabottom. I stationed him up there with his bow. Did you see him?
Neither him nor his body. You're the only survivor we found.
I see. I'll try to find out what happened to him. I must find him before reporting to Lord Commander Mormont.
The Night's Watch lacks the strength it once had. The wildling should never have been able to travel this far in the gift.
Take nothing for granted. Nothing lasts forever. We know that better than anyone.
I'll have my men sweep the area until our builders arrive to block up the opening. We'll take care of the slain. Good luck finding the boy, brother.
My thanks. I am greatly indebted to you, Corrin. Where did he go? He was supposed to be posted over here. Something happened here. If Gorn's men had killed Poddy, there would be traces of blood. He must have dropped his bow and abandoned this position when Gorn came upon us. I'll follow his tracks to find out where he ran off to. The footprints show that Poddy was alone. There can be no doubt. The Craven wasn't being chased by wildlings. He just ran. He headed south through the forest, straight towards Maulstown. If I don't catch him before he gets to the village, I'll lose his trail for good. This boy seems hot-tempered. I can feel his hostile nature from here.
My lord, you're a brother of the Night's Watch, are you not?
Yes. Why?
No reason. I was just curious. It's rare to come across your sort alone in the forest.
Speaking of which, what are you doing here?
I'm not alone, my lord. My family's not far.
Your family, you say? What brings you to this area?
Nothing special. We're always traveling, here and there. We buy, we barter, we sell.
You should join them. These woods may be under the protection of the Night's Watch, but it is not safe to walk here alone.
Very well, my lord.
Silence! Someone's coming!
Good day, my lord.
I crossed paths with a young man who claimed to be traveling in the area with his family. I imagine he was talking about you?
Indeed. He told us that he'd run into a brother of the Night's Watch. What can we do for you? We can sell you some equipment, if you wish.
Let's see what you have to sell.
Follow Aaron. He'll take you to our cart. Our father will show you what we have to offer.
Very well.
You don't see many crows around here.
I hope so.
How so?
You know of Maulstown, correct?
Aye. It's just about the only village around. And there are whores there. So, inevitably.
Exactly. And a Black Brother's place is at the wall. Not between some whore's thighs.
Well, a bit of fucking never hurt anyone.
That's not the issue. And anyway, it's none of your business.
I see.
No cart, eh? Just what I expected.
Greetings, my lord, from the Night's Watch. Another fool falls prey to the merchant ruse. It works every time.
I don't like your tone.
Oh, no reason to get upset. If you cooperate, we won't do you any harm. Give me your purse, your boots, your weapons, and all the rest of your valuables.
You don't know who you are speaking to, scum.
Indeed, a brother of the Night's Watch. Funny, isn't it? You're in charge of keeping the peace, and we've gone and robbed you.
Have you ever noticed how sometimes you come across a man best left alone? I am such a man.
That man is completely mad.
Two little whelps and their father. I won't even break a sweat.
You're right. After all, the more madmen, the merrier. This way, my friend. We have a customer.
I prefer this.
Since you don't wish to cooperate, we'll just help ourselves.
Come on.
Have mercy, my lord. Spare me, and I'll tell you where our stash is buried. You won't regret it. You'll be rich.
Gold holds no interest for me. Die, you bastard. These imbeciles can always try their tricks in the Seven Hells. Now let's return to Poddy.
Empty your pockets straight away.
Do not come any closer.
I will do as I please. I'm...
I'm done with this craven. It's time I returned and brought word of the Icemark mission to Mormont.
Ah, Mort, you're expected by the Lord Commander. He put me on lookout for you and ordered that you be sent to him as soon as you arrived.
Do you know why Mormont wants to see me?
One of Halfhand's men has arrived to bring tidings of Icemark. The wildlings, our brothers killed. It's a dark day for the Night's Watch.
I know. Winter is coming. You may go warm yourself, Lothar. I shall go see Mormont.
Hey.
Jor, Lothar told me that you wanted to see me as soon as I arrived.
Yes. One of Quarren the Halfhand's men arrived before you and told me what happened at Icemark. Have you found Poddy? Or his remains?
Poddy deserted. I tracked him down in the forest north of Molestown and managed to kill him just as he was attacking a young girl. I also took care of a couple of cutthroats I came across as they prepared to ambush passers-by.
raiders so near to Castle Black. If only we had enough men to send more patrols deep into the gift.
So, not a single one of these green boys will have survived his first day as a brother of the Night's Watch. I know enough about what happened there for now. Mors, there is another matter we must discuss. I don't know if you noticed the soldiers with the blue tabards downstairs. They're the men of John Arryn, the King's Hand.
Ah, the men you told me about before I left for Icemark. Those who came to meet me.
Yes. According to their message, they were looking for one of the heroes of Stag's Mount. You are the only one here who fits that description.
Do we know more about what they want from me?
Yes. They brought me a letter written by John Arryn. I'll let you read it. You can see for yourself what it's about.
Arryn, that sly old fox hasn't changed a whit. 15 years without a word, and all of a sudden he writes to beg a favor of me. I'm not even surprised.
Why are you receiving a personal missive from the King's Hand?
He's an old friend. We fought side by side in Robert Baratheon's rebellion. He saved my life more than once.
There is a passage that I don't understand. Mentions a girl, the darkness, and your wife, Serena. What does it mean?
Arryn is an intelligent man. This is a message only I can decipher. During the war, when we fought together, I never once used the services of a whore. Arryn knew and would tease me for it. He liked to say that I feared the darkness that lurked in brothels. I would reply that the thought of my wife was sufficient to clear away any darkness. The girl he mentions in his letter must be hidden in a whorehouse. The only one I know of nearby is in Molestown. Old Arryn knows me well. 15 years later, I'm still faithful to my wife.
It is good that you honor the chastity of our order, Mors. But are you doing it for the right reasons? Our vows are clear. We must leave behind our wives and children. If you are true to your oath, it must not be out of love for Serena, but out of respect for the Night's Watch.
I fulfill my duty, Jor. That's all you need to know. My memories are my own, and you cannot take them from me.
Be that as it may, he must have felt seriously threatened to write such a cryptic message. This does not bode well. I conferred with his emissary, Sir Godric Donnelly. He convinced me that his mission did not conflict with our duties. And if we help them, Arryn will convince King Robert to send us the recruits, materials, and supplies that we so sorely lack. Molestown is in the gift under the jurisdiction of the Night's Watch. You have my authorization to go there with Sir Godric.
Thank you, Jor. I will finally be able to repay my debt to John Arryn.
Remember, Mors, the Night's Watch does not interfere in politics. If for some reason you suspect that something is wrong, return to Castle Black.
Very well. I will go find this Godric. What do you want of me, Walder?
I have finished restoring the statuette that you entrusted me with just before you left to track down Gorold.
Really? Let's have a look.
I must say it was a true pleasure. Brothers normally ask me to paint them a pretty woman with big teats and spread legs. But I must say that this is a little more original. I realize we aren't the best of friends, but this statue is a work of art. I hope I treated it with the attention it deserved. I'm rather proud of my work. I returned it to its original colors, and it looks like new.
It's beautiful work, Walder. I have never seen such a striking likeness of the warrior. It's as if you have given him life.
It would appear the frost has not completely eaten away my hands. I hope you don't regret the price you paid for this job.
Not at all. This statue is worth more than you can imagine.
True. Actually, I have a vague idea of it. I've already seen this kind of work in the past, but only once, at the Great Sept of Baelor of King's Landing. I recall legends telling of statues made by the first disciples of the Seven, when they still strode the hills across the narrow sea. They were carved into a star that the Seven had torn from the heavens. These statues depicted the true face of the gods, just as they were when they showed themselves to the Andals.
And it is said that the Andals' greatest heroes carried them off when they snatched Westeros from the first men and the ancient gods.
How could a man such as yourself find himself in possession of such a precious object? I've never taken you to be such a devout man.
This statuette of the warrior has always belonged to my family, as far back as the bloodline stretches. It is because of this that he walks alongside us. Have you heard of the Battle of the Field of Fire?
Ah, now there's another great tale. At the time of Aegon the Conqueror's conquest, the Lannister King and the King of the Reach united their forces to fight the Targaryen and their dragons.
This is not just any old tale. This battle really took place, and it was the greatest massacre in the history of the Seven Kingdoms. On that day, more than 4,000 knights perished in the fire of those three great dragons. Aemory Westford, my ancestor, fought under the colors of the Lion, as is our duty. When the shadows of the dragons blotted out the sky, and their fire engulfed both men and beasts, he prayed for his life, as he had never done before. He swore then, on his immortal soul, that he would search for and gather all seven, collecting the six other statues which accompany the warrior. Aemory survived, and he set about his quest to give thanks to the Seven. He never succeeded, and our bloodline inherited his oath.
I imagine that faith comes more easily when one rushes into the jaws of such monsters. It's a beautiful tale, all the same. You know, I could maybe help you keep this ancient promise, Mors.
Let's just say that I'm interested. What do you hope to gain from it?
Sometimes it's pleasing to be able to work on something just because it's beautiful, Mors. What I want is to finish what I've begun, before I'm judged by the Father.
Would you do it for free?
I've not taken so much joy in anything since I chose to take the Black, and you know how important the faith is to me. If I could help you accomplish this sacred vow of your ancestors, I'd be paying homage to the gods for all their graces.
And how would you do that?
This statuette, it was created to be part of the Group of Seven.
Yes, we already spoke of it.
Wait, you don't understand. I've studied it closely, and I can tell you it was made to be bonded to other objects carved from the same strange rock. Probably a bracelet or an amulet that the Andal warriors bore, like the seven-pointed star they carved into their chests. I believe I'm capable of reconstructing such a work. More than 4,000 years after its imagining, it would be magnificent.
Truly a wonderful dream, Walder. But finding the other six gods would prove very difficult. And even if I did, imagine their state.
I can restore them, just as I brought the warrior back to life for you. These statuettes are not unique, though extremely rare. I told you I remember seeing three whole sets in the Great Sept of Baelor.
You speak of a world which is closed to us, my brother.
I'd be happy to share this dream with you. If you ever manage to lay your hands on another of these precious relics, I doubt it would be in good repair. But I can restore all their beauty for you.
I thank you, Warder. Indeed, your help would be invaluable to me.
Truly? Well, all that remains for me is to pray to the Seven that they finally bestow their kindness upon you, Morse.
We have what remains of our lives to find out.
May the warrior guide your arm and the crone light your way.
And may the father forgive you for everything else.
You're bloody right there, brother.
Supply frozen in the ice of the wall.